We're listening to The Bill Bennett Show.
All right, let's welcome Elaine Bennett to the show. And Claude, I'm going to step out and you will conduct this interview with your friend.
Yeah, I'll take it from here.
You'll take it.
Happy Thanksgiving, Claude.
Happy Thanksgiving, Mrs. Bennett. How are you?
I am just great. I'm so happy to see your face. It's been a while, and I know you're looking forward to Thanksgiving with your wonderful family.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We're having folks over. My sister is coming over, my brother-in-law, my niece, two friends that normally come over. My mom and brother aren't, and that's fine. You know, I will go past their house in the morning. But yeah, we're having everybody over. So
it's a thankful time. Mm-hmm. And it's a day that we have cherished in the Bennett household for a long time. Mm-hmm. When my boys were not able to join us, as Joe Bennett was not, when he was in the Marines and serving out in the San Diego area, Hugh Hewitt was kind enough, he and his wife, to invite Joe and some of his platoon members to their house for Thanksgiving.
Yes.
I was just a bit nervous because I wanted to be sure that Joe conducted himself accordingly, as I have tried through the years to impress some certain rules at the dinner table. And sometimes these rules were followed and sometimes they were not. So I made a list, Claude, I guess it was 10 years ago.
Yes.
maybe 8 years ago. And Bill shared this list on Morning in America. And he asked me to repeat it this Thanksgiving day.
And by the way, not only did Dr. Bennett ask you to repeat it, I've been getting emails from the podcast listeners since September asking if you were going to come on the show just to share the dinner table rules for Thanksgiving. And so it's a huge hit. We've had requests for us to post it on the Facebook page, for us to have you back on the show. And so obviously we have to do it.
Well, I'm honored. I am honored that this these rules were that impressive, and I'm happy to share them. I hope my boys are listening this morning. It's not a long list of rules. It's 12, but number one is napkin in the lap.
Right, first which is one I normally forget, but I've got to remember that first one. Napkin in the lap.
Before you pick up your fork, before you pick up your glass. Number two, drink from the glass or the glasses to the right over the knife.
Okay.
Can't go wrong.
Now, Mrs. Bennett, this is one that's not only for the consumer at the table, but for the one who sets the table, because you taught me this. I did not know that that's where the glass goes, to the right by the knife. And so this is a kind of a dual thing. And so if you're preparing the table or consumption, so it's kind of like we've got to work together on that.
These are rules that make it easy for everyone, and they are centuries old.
Nice.
So we are going to try to keep these long standing traditions going. Glass over the knife. Bread and butter and salad plate is to the left over the fork. Okay. So your code, Mrs. Hamlet taught me this in DC schools. Bread, meal, water. BMW. Bread, meal, water. That's a phrase we used. Bread to the left, meal in the middle, water to the right.
Got it.
And at our luncheons for best friends and best men students, they all got it, had it down cold. Privileged kids had a much harder time, especially my sons. Still working on it.
Okay. All right.
They're going to get it before they turn 40, I hope.
Yes, they will. They will.
Number four, no talking with your mouth full.
Yes.
Not ever a good thing. Number five, try very hard not to spill your food on the table or up the front of your shirt, and especially on your tie. Now, my boys are genetically predisposed to this behavior.
I was going to say, this sounds like a rule that's directed to someone who I work with closely on a weekly basis, especially the tie.
Yes, Claude, yeah. I think you're very perceptive there. Number six, you wait until the lady of the house is seated and has raised her fork.
Oh, okay.
if you, whoever is the hostess, especially if it's your mother or your grandmother, everyone waits respectfully until she has raised her fork. Now, also, and I know this will be happening at your house, you wait for a prayer or a blessing of the food.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So you wait for your hostess to be seated, and you look to her or to the host or to whomever will be blessing the food, and you join in that blessing. Mm-hmm. Be respectful of your guests or your family.
Sure.
Number 8, do not blow your nose at the table. If there's any need to blow your nose, you excuse yourself and you go to the powder room.
Okay.
That's an old-fashioned term where ladies would say, I must powder my nose. Men don't necessarily need to powder their nose, but they should definitely blow their nose in the nearest so-called powder room.
Got it?
Mm-hmm. Number 9, do not place the wine bottle, if you're having wine, on the floor by your chair. Now, that is a habit of the elder Mr. Bennett.
Okay, I was going to ask. This seems to be something that was inserted into the personal.
We're working on that one. Number 10, do not punctuate your sentences in any way with your silverware.
Ah, got it.
Especially, and we hope this isn't happening, but it could. Mm-hmm. This year, if you're having a political discussion, do not wave your knife around or jab your fork directly in front of you. Number 11, always, always personally thank the hostess and tell her the food was delicious.
Mm-hmm.
That will warm her heart.
Now, I would imagine if there's a situation where multiple people are bringing food, mm-hmm. if you know of an individual who cooked a specific dish, thank them as well.
That is a good point. Okay. Yes, seek out in situations which are really wonderful where different people bring different dishes. Mm-hmm. You will warm that person's heart by saying that green bean casserole was just delicious.
Nice.
And it's especially important to say how delicious the food is.
Okay.
If you have left enough food on the floor under your chair for the family dog's next meal, the hostess will not be as offended if you have complimented her food explicitly.
Mm-hmm.
Number 12, if you want your mother to go to her grave, or if she's already passed on and she's watching you from up above, and you want her to feel peaceful and as if she has been a successful mother, you offer to clear the table, take out the garbage, and always follow up with a handwritten thank you note, second choice is email, within 3 days. This is important if it's a hostess, someone you're being a guest at someone's table, or if it's your own mother.
Oh, okay.
Right. I have on file all handwritten notes I have received from youngsters.
Okay.
Shared our dinner, and especially our Thanksgiving dinner.
And that does it for today's show. To catch up on previous episodes of the show, go to thebillbennettshow.com. You can follow me on Twitter at William J. Bennett, and you can like me on Facebook. Just search Bill Bennett. Feel free to email the show. I'd love to hear from you. It's BillBennettPodcast@gmail.com. Please share the podcast with your family and friends. We'll catch up next week.